Yeah, I'm Andre from Denmark. I'm sailing the Finn, doing an Olympic campaign. I'm studying here in Aarhus and living here in Aarhus. So this is my base. So I'm looking really much forward to sail on home waters, since we're always sailing in the South Europe or overseas. It's nice to be in Denmark actually. I've been sailing the Finn for probably around 4 years now, and I started in the Finn because my physics was due to that boat, and I loved the fact that it was a little bit physical in the free pumping part and stuff like that, and also the part that you can develop a little bit on the equipment. It's really, really nice, and then we have some good history in the class in Denmark, so that's also nice. We have Paul Enstrom, which was the first one to show the Finn how it should be sailed, and develop a lot of stuff in the beginning. And then afterwards we have Steve Estergaard and Lasse Hjortnes, former world champs and stuff like that. And then we have Jonas Høgh Christensen, which was taking silver in London. And I was actually a part of his campaign up to Rio, and he asked if we wanted to join him on his program, so we could learn a lot from him. And I said yes, and took on a journey which started out actually in America, in the States, where the former Olympic medalist from USA, Zach Raley, also was joining in our group, and learned big amount of things from these guys. Yeah, it was just taking me to the skies pretty fast. So it's up to me to qualify the country. Yeah, in Denmark is the first option. So hopefully I'll do that. I've done my preparation. In the Finn, we need to do a lot of physical stuff, because it's a tough boat to sail, and they have chosen to do this free pumping, which is putting even more of the physical stuff into the boat. So. On a daily basis, I would have a training session on the water, and also in the gym, or on the bike, or in the rowing machine. Actually, I think it's soon to be half-half. You use half of the time in the boat and half of the time in the gym, or on the bike, or in the rowing machine. The thing is also that hiking is really, really hard for specific muscles. So you can try to put on different load on the same muscles, so you don't have that many injuries over time. Food is also a big part of the sailing. The nutrition is a big part of the sailing, we have found out, compared with all the other stuff. When I started in the Finn, I just wanted to put on a lot of weight, so I just basically ate what I wanted to eat. And then, but over the time, when I'm on weight, then I've tried to work with some specialists about having the right amount of the different protein and carbohydrates. Yeah, that's the word. they built the boat exactly for you. So every boat is like individual. Yeah, boats, like it's your boat. When I made my boat, I said I'm this kind of guy, I'm weighing this much and stuff like that, and then so that's quite cool. The Finn is a little bit special in that sense. It's a boat where you can, there is some maximums and minimums that you can work inside, and that makes the work with the equipment a lot more than compared to the lasers, for example. I use probably 20% of the time trying to find out which sail or which mast or which boom or rudder I wanna sail with. The boat is more or less fixed to one boat builder right now, which is making the best boat. So that's quite easy. But still, they are trying to make better boats all the time, this boat builder. So sometimes you maybe have to change that as well. When I started in the Finn, my equipment was what I've just... You begin in the Finn and then you buy a boat and buy a mast. But as soon as Jonas took me into his program, he had been developing in maybe 10 years at that time on Mars and stuff like that. So that made my progress really, really big, because I got some of his equipment, especially the Mars he had at that time was really, really good. And And then right now I have actually also one of his masks he used in Rio, and it's very, very good. And we have found out something special with the mask, I think. These things with the equipment is also have something to do with the mind, yeah. And people wanna keep a little bit silent and try to say, okay, we have something special here, because when they are fast, I think, yeah, pretty much that's the thing with making the boat rigging simple is general in sailing. I think over the time there is developed a lot of stuff, but right now we have found out, okay, we have to take a lot of this stuff out and then make it in this new simple way. Yeah, less is more, I think is the saying. We try all the time to all the trim lines and that stuff. We try to do them as good as possible, so we can change gear as fast as possible. So yeah, you have come up with these friction wings from big boat sailing, and guys are starting to use them now in a smaller version. I use lead rings on my kicking system, for example, so it runs smooth and easy, and they are really, really light, also compared to the block. And it makes the trimming much more easy, especially going downwind. I use Harken in my boat, and it's really, really nice equipment. I think it's always working. I haven't had any problem with it yet, so it's cool, and it's light, so that's also really, really nice for us. Light and efficient. If Harken could make anything new, it could be really, really nice to have adjustable main block system, which would be very, very flexible with the angle.